back and look at it.
Okay. After they graduated.
Memorial, and we'll be going there, and there also is the
Washington Monument is planted with 898 steps.
Be careful
just, you know, it's, sometimes it's awful easy to lay a camera down and walk away, and you've forgotten it. And hopefully you'll find it and you go back. But if you carry it with you all the time, you wouldn't have to worry. There you can see the Capitol. This is the west side of the Capitol. This is the side of the Capitol that all of the inaugurations recently have been conducted. Because what it does is it gives you more of an area here. I'll show you the east side, which is very, very small. See those people over there lined up on the steps over there? They're taking pictures. And what we'll do is we'll be going there too, because you're going to have your picture taken. They do a very, very nice job. Another one of the main roads, and this is Constitution. You've got Independence, Constitution, and Pennsylvania. They're probably the primary one. Now, as far as Washington, D.C. goes, the District of Columbia was really established around the year 1800. It was decided to have the Capitol here, and so in order to build the Capitol, what they did is they asked the state of Virginia and the state of Maryland to give them property along the Potomac River. They did, and they started building. Incredibly enough, all of the building was done on the Maryland side, so Virginia got their property back again. You can see an awful lot of memorials here. Most of them are to Civil War generals. Coming up here on the right, this is the embassy for Canada, right on our right. It's the only one that's on Pennsylvania Avenue. Now, I think you know that an embassy is where the ambassador has his office, and they also have legations, which they don't have an ambassador, but they have somebody who's very high, but not an ambassador. We have in excess, believe it or not, in excess of over 150 countries that have representation here in Washington, D.C. Most of the buildings on our right, these are private buildings. Coming up here on the right bridge very shortly is the Navy Memorial. It's one of the newer ones. And strangely enough, all of the water that's in there is supposed to be have samples from all of the seven seas have been dumped into there to make it a real Navy-type memorial. Over here on our left, this is the Department of Justice, and I think that it's only apropos because right across the street with all the American flags flying out of it, that is the FBI building. And we'll be going here, making a turn, and seeing what the line looks like. So keep your fingers crossed.
Hey,
here, man,
that's kind of relaxed for
tourists.
Things
really
relaxed, of course, the amount of tourists
that
we've seen so far this year. We had maybe 1 or 2 weekends where it was
really great. Yeah, I think when they had all the orange belt kids here, that was an experience.
Yeah,
I bet. Up over to our left here, this rather ornate building. This is the old post office building, sometimes referred to as the pavilion. This is a Romanesque architecture, if you're interested. What happened is that originally it was a post office, but then the post office people decided they didn't need it anymore. So what they did is they put it to use by storing things. And then suddenly they decided, well, let's do away with the building. And suddenly everybody got up in arms because it was, they felt that it was such a beautiful building, there was no sense in tearing it down. So what they did is they converted it. Now what you'll find is you'll find offices on the top couple floors. Down below they have a many different kinds of food are being served there, as well as there's a nice steeple that people can go up. Over here on the left, you see that red building there? That is the Ford's Theater. And you can see it's kind of busy here. But For those of you who are interested, you see this line over here to the left. You'll see it. It goes up to one of these doors here, right on this. Right. See where they went in the door right there? This is the Hard Rock Cafe, and there's where they have their sales office, right in there. So you want to come along with me and check the crowd out? The people that are in town by looking at all the buses. So the people have left the city itself and have moved out to the suburbs, and this is where you find most of your stores are out there in the suburbs, in the shopping mall. As I was saying a little bit about the history about Washington, Pierre Lafont, a Frenchman who was here in the United States, fought with us during the Revolution. He was the one, he was an engineer, and he laid out the city of Washington. Unfortunately, he and George Washington, who actually helped survey this area and also picked the site for the White House, he got along not too well with Pierre Lafont, and the next thing you know, Pierre Lafont was fired. However, the Washington as we see it today is pretty much exactly the way he laid it out. What we've got, if you can imagine, it's a layout with squares on it, and then you have these streets like the one we're on right now, Pennsylvania, that run sort of cattywampus, if you will. And we go along here, you're going to see a flag, and this flag has three red stars on it and two red bars. This is the flag of the District of Columbia, and the design came from part of the coats of arms of George Washington.
We should be able to see. see the presidential box, but I mean,
do you want to back the camera?
This is our first day in Washington, D.C., and we are really tired.
their bottom area where they have all of the different kinds of foods, almost any kind of food you want, from Chinese all the way up to Italian pizza. Now, I would like to say that when we get here, the restrooms, when you go downstairs, the restrooms, modern paintings and architecture and statuary. The other, the west, is where they have the more traditional Rembrandts and the like. Over on our left here, this is the Department of Labor, and the building is named for Frances Perkins. Frances Perkins, of course, was the one of the first women who ever served in a cabinet, and she served in the cabinet with Franklin D. Roosevelt. Coming up here on the right, you're going to see a tower with a statue, and of course, this is the statue to Senator Robert Taft. He was a very famous senator. And they have the carillons there. In other words, they've got bells, and they do play the bells during the day. That's on our right. And you can see directly ahead, you can see the Union Station. Now, just again, I'm sure that you did it in your area, too. The reason that the flag is flying at half-mast is because of the 30 days that President Clinton deemed for ex-President Nixon.
Thank you. Thank you.
starter, coffee. For starter. And then they live up on the,
Where?
Turn you loose.
Arlington Cemetery. Those here right in the front row are quite a few people from the Korean War complex. Where are they?
To put all your wards that he's won.
That's
going to
sound like a struggle to come on.
This is once again, it's true. It all means the same thing. Their memory. Now, over here on the left, this is Challenger, and Dick Scooby, who was the commander of the Challenger. He's the only one that's buried here in Arlington. All the rest are buried somewhere else. Now, this cross, and did you see here? That's what's known as the Canadian Cross of Valor. And what they did, the Canadians put that up in memory of all the Americans who fought and died with the Canadian forces. So that's the Canadian Cross of Honor. Okay, I'll ask you to backtrack here.
All right.
said.
Yeah, you want to get in and get in the picture?
And we're marching. Here we go.
Over here, a little one, you can take a look at it. It's right in there. It's
chill.
Whoa, extreme close-up. Better not be a May. Okay.
Okay. This is...
Thank you.
Washington Cathedral.
Thank you. ice every Friday. So I threw a church 30 Fridays in a row. Got a lot of overtime.
There
it
is.
Vaughn.
Vaughn!
Can you call this is our friend. This is me.
Yeah, I wanted
to hear everything going on. And I'm excited that if we heard something and we didn't hear, that we should break the door down. Ladies, all the ladies. Smoking a cigarette, having a break. Nothing much. Thanks, Annette. Does anyone have anything to say? Do you guys have anything to say?
Is that red hair or dark hair?
Thanks, guys. I love you all.
This is the awakening, huh?
Yeah.
Sort of like the...
Cheeks are getting sore. what they say. They say walking fast is better than jogging, you know. It is.
Look around, if I'm playing, I pull it.
The
Can't even see her, so I won't feel it.
Tours of other museums and galleries make New York the art center not only of this country, but of the world.
I don't know. What's the matter?
I don't know. I thought that was going to be a
that
safe in.
She is.
We're zooming in, Larry.
She is.
We're really in. Larry, we're zoomed in.
What a mess.
Whoa. Whoa. Hey, wait, we're zooming in. It kind of got blurry there.
Jim, is Vince trying it?
Yeah, they are, I think.
Did you pay your pants?
Hey, I did this right.
Hey, your pants are
wet. Wait, I gotta get it.
Zoom in.
Look at myself.
Hey.
Yeah.
Center and the American Museum of Immigration. Please step down to the main deck at this time. Ellis Island will be our stop. Group leaders, please assemble your groups at this time and please step down to the lower deck if you would like to go ashore. The next stop this boat makes will be back to Battery Park in New York City. Battery Park, Manhattan will be our next stop. Boats depart from Ellis Island at 10 minutes to the hour and 20 minutes past the hour.
What's that down there? Kind of wood, like a dock.
Yeah.
Skyline.
Authentic sports games and access to the internet on your TV. Play games, surf the net only on Sega Saturn.
Mulder and Scully uncover the government's most terrifying conspiracy.
These people are test subjects.
The X-Files. A brand new episode next.
no deal.
Excuse me?
Excuse me?
Excuse me?
No deal. What do you want, Mr. Dorsey? What we want, Phil Dog, is this amount. Penny less will be an insult. This figure is ridiculous. Well, I guess you're free to go then. That's it. I'm out of here.
Hold on. Let's not be hasty. No, I mean, I'm going. Yeah.
If you folks don't want to sell, that's fine. We'll build around you. Goodbye.
Wait. We were almost home. I want to go home. There's no place like home.
So, how'd it go?
Actually, Rico, I blew the deal.
What, Ned, she quit her job for this deal.
I'm sorry. I'll make it up to you somehow.
So, how'd it go?
Your lunatic fake husband blew the deal.
Don't appreciate the name calling.
Why did you do it, Ned?
I told you I had a dream that made it uncomfortable for me to sell the muffin shop. Why is that so hard to understand?
Ned, you didn't have to blow the deal. I mean, I've got dreams, too. You don't see me pursuing them.
Look, why am I the bad guy in this scenario? She made me have the dream.
Huh? What did I say?
You said I couldn't imagine what it was like to be anyone but me. So, I had the dream. And in the dream, I was everyone in the muffin shop. You know, I couldn't throw me out of here. I love me too much.
Don't worry, honey. Ned said he'd make it up to us. Now, come on, Ned. You tell us how you're going to make it up to us.
With muffins.
I'm sorry. I could have sworn you said muffins when the only thing you could have said is that you're going to write me a check.
A check? Can you spread butter on a check? Can a check warm you up with its blueberry goodness? Can a check be of any use to a starving man? No. Well, yes, but that aside, let's keep this place going, huh?
Did someone slip me some blotter acid, or are you seriously suggesting that we run a muffin shop?
Not we, you. I have a job.
I was trying to cheer you up, Mike.
I'm kidding.
Oh, come on. You know, I didn't like it either until I looked at the books. It turns out that old lady's been gouging her customers for years.
I'm going to run a muffin store.
Muffin store. Look, honey, you try it for a while. You always wanted to be your own boss. Now you can berate yourself. Wasn't funny. Okay. Look, we'll try it for a while, and if you still don't like it, we'll try something else, okay?
I guess.
Okay. Come on. Let's get some sleep. Don't forget, set the alarm for 4:30.
Doing out here?
Just looking through the telescope. Oh, I'm sorry. I totally forgot. It's your telescope. It's your stars. It's your moon.
Okay. Sorry. I guess things have gotten a little out of hand. Sorry I didn't share my food with you. Sorry I wrote on your face. Sorry. Put your hand in warm water while you were sleeping. Sorry I switched your regular coffee with Folgers crystals.
You did? I couldn't tell. Hey, Hey, is that Mercury, or is that just a really bright star?
Well, that little lady happens to be... Yeah, actually, I have no idea. I've never pointed this thing at the sky before. Don't have a good reading on it. Anyway, so... I have a date. How do I look? All right, don't wait up.
Oh, I have a date, too, so I'll see you later.
Okay.
Bye.
You need it most. Braun Style Shaper, one hot little hairbrush. Braun has a range of cordless stylers and curling irons to keep your hair looking beautiful.
Inside the vehicle until the ride comes to a complete stop.
Buy the powerful Sega Saturn gaming system between now and the end of the year, and we'll give you three of Sega Saturn's top-selling arcade games free. That's Virtua Cop, Daytona USA, and Virtua Fighter 2. $189 worth of games, absolutely free. So hurry, luck like this just won't last.
I want a piece of you. Prepare for these old flabby guns. Prepare for these old flabby guns to start pumping. Prepare for these iron guns to start pounding your sissy warships. right away.
No.
Stop laughing!
Good night. Whoa. Good night.
Good cheer and muffins throughout one Bay Area neighborhood.
Fox 13 Eyewitness News at 6, Monday on Florida's News Leader.
Over the past 13 years, no other import manufacturer has sold as many sport utility vehicles as American Isuzu Motors. But hey, why stop at 13? Right now you can lease a 97 Rodeo for some of the lowest prices of the year during the great Isuzu Fall Clearance Event. The rugged, dependable, go-anywhere Isuzus.
As tonight's stormy weather finally comes to an end, satellite pictures show that clearing skies are on the way. I'll have the complete forecast after the X-Files.
Chris Rock hosts the 1996 Billboard Music Awards live Wednesday on Fox.
Previously on the X-Files.
Don't do it, Mulder!
What's in this rock we intercepted? Our answer is beyond the existence of extraterrestrial life.
Whatever's in that rock, it appears to be lethal.
CIA airport intel had a name come across their computers, but for Krasnoyarsk, Russia, Fox Mulder.
What are they doing? Looks like some kind of mining camp. I don't think they're miners.
Perjury is a very serious offense, particularly for an FBI agent.
Thank you.
mind, Jim.